Anyway, put it to test. Let me know what happens. If they please react to this tape, we're very much interested. We want to know how far we can go in the science of attempting developing a science of communication. You can call it the limitations of communication, whatever you want to call the tape. Toward a science of communication, an impossible attainment at present. Now, if you can suddenly input into a person's head without having them go through all the experience, if you can implant a system of communication like what people talk about when they say instinctive behavior, if you can do that with robots. When he sees a fire, he puts it out. When he sees an automobile accident, he opens the door to get the people out. If the people don't seem to move after certain tests, he calls the morgue. If there's some life, he calls the hospital. Or it calls the hospital. Does it care? That doesn't matter. What matters is, does the robot do the right thing at the time? If the robot bites his nails and says, I'm so sorry about the accident, it doesn't make people any better. So you don't want a robot that feels sorry for people. You want a robot that calls an ambulance and calls a certain type of physician if the bones are broken. If the robot knows how to do that, you don't give a shit about its philosophy. Do you understand what I'm saying? So how intelligent do you want a robot to be? What kind of service do you want of the robot? That's why if an inventor gives a robot the pleasing smell of a rose and all that, the robot would have behavior superfluous to your needs if he goes around smelling roses all day long. But if he goes around killing insects that spread disease, that would be to your advantage. So you wouldn't want a robot that had any information superfluous to the need for your creation of that robot. All you want of an automobile is transportation. You don't want it to bitch about the weather, because you can't do anything about that. But if you say to the robot, what kind of weather do you want? The robot says, pleasant weather. Do you know how to do that? No. Then shut up. The robot will shut up. Even a robot can understand that. If you can't control the weather, you can't make any contributions. If you design a ship that can go under the water when there's a storm, you know, like a submarine, you don't need to be subject to the big waves. So remember, a submarine is designed to support people underwater. Rarely, it's not designed to support people flying through the air. Until one day submarine can come out of the water and fly through the air, then it would have to be quite different. Do you understand? The same with people. Depends on their range of operation. This is all related. Whether people will see that relationship, that's something else. Depends on their background, not how smart they are. Background meaning having information that can put this together. You can wrap it up. And that's why semantics have really very little use. I said very little use. Not everything is totally lost up. It's just less relevant. I would never seek a science of communication, because I would only have limited tools to work with. Even whatever I came up with would be of temporary use. But chemotropism is a direct kind of communication. Some ants follow not other ants but formic acid, and they have chemotropism, which is more direct. There are ants that are warriors, and there are ants that feed the mother ant. That's chemotropism. It's better than learning, you know what I mean? Because all the ants want is certain behavior. They don't know that. You can't ask an ant, what do you want? That's why we can communicate someday with ants by changing the chemistry of the environment. We can change the tropism. You know what I mean? That would be communicating with ants. This is very broad. I'd like you to spin it, test it out, let me know what kind of reaction you get from that alone. I would be very interested by the Zeitgeist people, or people who really are interested in social change. And they say, well, what do you recommend to evolve a communication system within the physical reference of an existing culture? And understand when you're doing that, what you're doing. You're not really communicating, you're improving communication within the realm of a given culture. As long as you know what you're doing, it's all right. So I'd like to know the spin-off from this type of delivery. Whether it's too difficult, whether people say, I disagree with you completely. Well, they couldn't possibly agree immediately. But a person says, you've given me a lot to think about. I can't answer that immediately, but give me about 2 or 3 weeks to toss it around. I may have some questions then. That's better than saying, I completely disagree with you. So I'm giving you tools, the advanced tools, so you have to stay away from trying to communicate with other people. You only communicate to whatever extent you can. Do you understand that? I'm speaking to you people here. If you understand it, I don't know how other people will react. That's the truth. I really don't know. It may be too heavy. It may be a system in between the systems. I don't know. But anyway, put it to test. I'd be very curious to know, particularly people who call themselves open-minded, which I don't believe exists. I don't believe I'm open-minded or anybody else.
That concludes this lecture on communication by Jacque Fresco. If these talks are helpful to you, be sure to subscribe to the channel, add as friend, like, and also add to your favorites lists. For more information, visit thevenusproject.com. where you'll find free downloads including ebooks, photo galleries of Jacque Fresco's original designs of city systems, cities in the sea, energy, transportation, housing, and much more. Be sure to visit the FAQ section where you'll find over 100 of the most frequently asked questions. For further information, visit the store where you'll find books, CDs, DVDs, and more. All sales and donations help support the project. Thanks.